Well, it was the decade Taste forgot. Turn back time to the 70s in an hour after River City.
Doesn't matter. I'll speak to you later.
One large whiskey.
Put that back. Yeah, Eggnum. Get out.
No!
Told you not to tell anybody.
They're family. They're not just empty.
You are unbelievable.
What more do you need?
He loves you.
I want to have a baby and a family, and I actually want a husband who'll talk to me about our marriage before he goes and talks to his mom.
Raymond, do you know where Stuart's wee aeroplane bib is?
Yes!
What?
We've been nominated for Scottish Community Pub of the Year.
Oh, fantastic. Well done. Oh, you're a nominee.
Yes. Firstly, I'd like to thank my son, Stuart, without whose help and support I would not be standing in front of you today.
And what about me?
I don't think Stuart would want to share the credit.
Oh, I think he'd be cool with that.
Right, the brewery are sending round a photographer, so I'm going to get downstairs gleaming.
Well, make sure you don't leave those scabby Bartels out on the counter.
Oh, you think? I was going to feature them.
Oh, and if it's going to be an awards ceremony, Stuart will need a new outfit. And so will I.
Oh, will you?
Oh, that is great stuff, Stevie. But no, look, I don't just want a hand with the cleaning. I want you in the photos as well. Yes, with Zinny. She's on tonight. I think you'll cope. I need more young people in the photo, you know, for a bit of age balance. Hey, I'll have you know I've still got all my own teeth. Okay, pal, that's great. I'll see you then. Okay, see ya.
How's your gun, Raymond?
You dirty low-life scumbag.
Is there something I said?
Replace my stock and pay for the damage.
What are you talking about?
Just get it done, eh?
Is it your pal lost his marbles here?
What's happened? Tow ship's been broken, ain't he? All the stock's been taken for the gantry. The place has been trashed. You can check the details with him.
You're way out of line.
I'm going to get the police involved.
Yeah? I don't have a problem with that.
I'm going to phone them right now.
Go on. You my guest.
Raymond, hang on!
Don't you try and tell me that he didn't do it.
But why would he?
Because he didn't like the way I spoke to him the other night. And that's enough for a psycho like him.
I can't see it.
You can't? You're forgetting he took the pub off me a few years back.
Things changed, Raymond. I mean, Lenny's changed.
You're deluding yourself, pal. If he's changed, it's only for the worse.
Look, do you want a hand to clear up?
No. Stevie's going to help me. You better get back to your boss.
Raymond!
Did you have to decide to pick a fight with Lenny Murdoch again?
I did not pick a fight with Lenny Murdoch.
Have you spoke to him?
Just had it out with him just now. Denies it, of course.
Right, that's it. Call the cops.
Lenny was very keen I did just that.
So?
So it means we won't be able to trace it back to him. So we'd be wasting our time.
Well, you have to make him aware you're not just going to take this. And we need a police report for the insurance claim. Right, what's wrong?
Remember we had that faulty alarm?
You never got it fixed?
No.
So, The insurance won't cover us.
I'll phone the brewery, I'll cancel the photo call.
Sometimes I wonder if you've still got the brains you were born with, Raymond.
Then I'll call the suppliers and see if we can get an advance on some more stock.
Yeah, because you've really got them over a barrel.
Do you want me to start the tidy up?
Yeah, cheers, pal. Listen, I didn't want to say anything in front of Eileen, but I am not taking this line down.
Raymond, you need to be careful.
Oh, I will be.
Oh, you're finished, son?
No way.
Suck on that, die.
Gutted.
What are you two playing at?
The new RPG.
I mean, why are you still here? You're going to be late for football camp.
Right, let's go. One more.
No point. I am the chosen one.
Oh, come on.
Am I invisible here?
Mum, it's not like school. You don't need to be on time.
Oh, really? I don't think so.
Right, come on. We've got time for one more.
Yeah.
No.
But we've got time.
Go and get ready.
Actually, I'm still nursing an injury.
You will be if you don't get a move on.
And I forgot to get my strip washed.
Well, I didn't. I put a clean one in your kit bag last night. Go and get your kit!
Haley?
Morning.
What's the... Oh, God. I'm so sorry. I'm supposed to have opened up this morning.
Yep.
I'll be there in 2 minutes.
No, don't worry. Nobody's until 10:30 anyway. Set the kit on.
Okay.
So how are you feeling?
Did I make up your tube of myself last night?
No, you didn't. But I was in left no doubt that you were going to miss me.
Is that greeting?
A little bit.
Drama queen.
So, I got a call from my prospective buyer this morning.
And?
He's agreed the price.
Well, that's brilliant.
Hmm.
What is it?
I don't like him.
So, like his money instead?
I know it sounds stupid, but it's important for me to like who's taken over number 18. But I was thinking, what about you?
What about me?
Would you consider taking it over?
Oh, Hen. I'm touched that you'd ask, I really am, but where am I going to get that kind of money? It's never going to happen.
Even at a special Robbie discount?
How much? Oh, what am I saying? I won't waste your time. Take his money and run.
Right, okay. I'll go and open up the shop. You get some breakfast and I'll see you shortly.
Thanks.
And get some mints.
Oh, I will. Goal! He does it again. He's the new Messi.
Why aren't you two away?
We've decided we're not going.
It's trap.
What do you mean I paid for 3 weeks of that camp?
It's full of little kids.
It's just embarrassing, Mum.
Well, can't you help the coach then?
He's a daddy.
Strike back. Shoot.
Well, I'm telling you, I'm not pouring my money down the drain. You're going to that camp.
No way.
Connor, this isn't up for debate.
Yeah, 2 weeks, we're not doing it.
Hey, don't talk to your mother like that.
She's not my mother.
Right, that's it. Move it.
Uncle Gabe.
Now! Can I be checking these both turned up?
Thank you.
No sweat.
Thank you. That says at Loch Lomond on a day trip. That says at the opening of number 18. That's when we went to George Square for New Year. Oh, that one is when...
I get the picture.
I'm going through a trauma here and you don't care.
We're all going to miss Hayley.
Every photograph is a memory. A shared moment of precious time.
Not just a bunch of snap, happy, pished folk.
I can't bear your attitude. I'm going to make copies of these, especially for Hayley. I want her to take the people of Shield Inch away with her when she goes.
So I'm in them too?
Everybody is.
But mainly Robbie.
It's me she'll miss the most.
What's happening with the salon, by the way? Any decisions yet?
She's got an interested buyer, but she doesn't like the guy. She asked me to buy her out.
Fantastic.
No, not fantastic. Rotten timing. I finally get the chance to realise my dream, but I can't do it.
Why?
That little thing called money, Deke.
How much is she asking?
Well, she only wants paid for stock and fittings and maybe a wee bit extra as goodwill.
So, how much?
$8,000, but she was asking 12.
Thanks. Robbie, that is a steal.
Well, she's got a rich man now.
Can you not get a bank loan?
Are you kidding?
Sorry. I forgot it was your overdraft that cost Fred Goodwin his job.
Oh, ha-ha.
Seriously, though, be a real shame to miss that opportunity.
Story of my life.
And what can I do for you now? You come to apologise?
I'm going to ask you outright. Did you break into my pub or instruct others to break in?
Oh, Henderson QC. You know, your cheek's truly remarkable.
Look, I'm not going to pursue it with the police. We can call a truce. But I need to know, was it you?
Truce? You ever heard the likes of this? I told you, I know nothing about it.
Is this your way of getting back at me?
For what?
For the way I spoke to you the other night, because see if it is, I could put all that aside as a misunderstanding.
You know, this is starting to sound like a broken record. Why don't you call the cops you keep talking about, eh? Tell me to pursue the guilty parties with the full force of the law, you get me?
And if we called this truce, I would ask you to return the bottles from the gantry.
How do I return what I don't have? Why don't you just call your suppliers, get some more in? Am I being too sensible here?
You can't just order replacements for a rare malt and liqueur collection that you've built up over the years. It would cost a fortune.
Insurance! Get on your insurance, man! Oh. No insurance. Ah, well. I'll tell you what. I'll even lend you the money, eh? Low interest rates.
Why are you doing this to me, eh? Why are you crucifying me? You've not caused enough misery in Shield Inch. I'll tell you this, Lenny Murdoch. I, for one, will not!
Why are you doing this to me? Why are you crucifying me? You've not caused enough misery in Shield Inch.
Can you believe that?
Come on, Raymond, let's go. Come on.
You're scum, Murdoch. Scum!
Come on.
It was just random.
I'm just saying it could have been. You know, any wee Ned could have done it.
Oh, I've got an alibi.
Listen, good job, Stevie. Here, you still got that van?
Aye.
You're going to nip up to the cash and carry for me. Get a couple of crates of mixers, some crisps, nuts, that sort of thing. Just something to be going on with while I work out what's what.
Nay, bother. How did it go, babe?
Not good. Listen, Lenny Murdoch's had it in for me for years. He's just looking for an excuse.
Look, I'm not defending him here, right? But I just don't think that's the kind of thing he does.
You don't think? Gabriel, get real. You're acting like that scumbag's a human being.
Now, all right, keep the heat. Right, what can I do to help?
That's exactly what I was about to say. I heard about your brother, eh? Any idea who?
Lenny Murdoch. I can't prove it, but I know it was him.
I wouldn't put it past him, eh? How are you going to get your gantry restocked?
Well, that's the thing. Stupid appearance here blew it with the insurer, so I'm going to have to get hold of my suppliers and try and get a line of credit.
Yeah, that's what I was saying when I came in, eh? Maybe I can help you. I've got a mate in the wholesale trade. You'll have your bar stocked in no time.
Yeah, but the thing is, I need to be open again by tonight or I'm in real shtook.
I can make this happen right now, eh, if you want. And your suppliers match that.
I don't know. I've been dealing with these guys for years.
Look, fair enough. But if you work out what you need, how much they're going to charge you, I'll make sure my guy undercuts it by 30%. No cash needed up front. You just pay me back when you're back on your feet, sorted.
Can I think about it?
Of course. The offer's there, right, if you need it. If you don't take us out on it, any hard feelings.
Right, cheers. It's just my head's mince with this.
Yeah, look, I understand. You just take your time. I like Raymond. That's why I'm making him an offer.
Sure.
And it's also good to noise up Lenny.
If it was him.
Who else?
Look, I know what you're saying, Sean, but he's telling me that he wasn't involved.
Well, he would do, I mean, wouldn't he?
True.
Right, I've got things to do. I'll see you later, right?
See you.
Gabriel, have a word with Raymond. Convince him that this is a good deal, right?
Can it?
Sorry, I was dreaming.
I take it you've heard what happened this morning.
I was just talking to Raymond about it.
I think it was Lenny.
Look, Eileen, I don't really want you.
Come on, Gabriel. You must have an opinion.
Well, I told Raymond that I didn't think it was something that Lenny would do.
Are you serious? This is Lenny Murdoch we're talking about.
Look, if you don't like my opinion, then don't ask for it, all right?
I was just saying.
Sorry, but I think I better go.
You better.
Robbie, I've got a proposal.
Sorry, I'm already spoken for.
I don't want to talk about it on the phone. Let's meet ASAP.
Oh, man of mystery.
Can you come round to mine?
Sure. I've got a break coming up. Okay, bye. So it's this big proposal.
Right. I've worked it all out. Worked what out?
A plan.
What plan?
A plan to finance the purchase of number 18. You'll be the creative maestro, I'll be the money man, but with a clause in our contract to allow you to buy in when you can afford it, basically. What do you think?
I don't know.
Well, 2 hours ago, this was your life's dream.
It is, but I'm scared.
It'll be a partnership. I'll be there to help you.
No, what I mean is I'm scared I'll waste your money. Blowing your own money's one thing, but...
Robbie, I can do this. I've even squared it with the bank manager. I can access the money. You've got the talent. You can't fail.
Oh, my God, that's exciting, though.
So? Deal?
Deal. I think. I don't know. OK, deal.
OK. Now we just need to speak to Hayley.
Can I do that on my own? Do you mind?
No, that's fine. I need to speak to my lawyer and get a simple contract drawn up.
I can't believe this is happening.
Gabriel.
Hi.
I wanted to thank you for helping me sort out the boys this morning.
Least I could do.
I'm genuinely grateful.
It was nothing. I'm sorry, I need you.
All right, could I maybe see you later then, after work?
What about?
I need to speak to you, that's all.
Okay.
I'll call you when I'm done then.
Sure. Raymond, you in there?
Yeah, come on in.
Looking good? Listen, have you thought any more about Sean's offer?
Yeah, I was going to ask you. Is he straight up, this guy?
As far as I know, Raymond.
It's hardly a ringing endorsement.
Well, I mean, I don't know who his suppliers are. I'm presuming they're all kosher.
Well, Lenny's not a pal of his, and that's one thing in his favour. Sorry, I should lay off you and Lenny being partners.
Well, if I saw it. I mean, business is business.
So you reckon I should take Sean's offer?
Well, it's up to you, Raymond. I mean, I really couldn't.
I know. The truth is, I don't really have a ready alternative. I checked my supplier's price and it'd be a killer right now, especially with my insurance being up the spout. And Sean's offer of a discount with no money up front.
Well, I guess it's a no-brainer on your situation then, isn't it?
Pretty much, don't you think?
Well, hi, man. Go for it. I'm sure you'll be fine.
How do I reach him then?
Don't worry about it. I'll get a hold of him. Have you any idea what you need?
Yeah, actually, I've made a list.
Yeah, okay. I'll get back to you.
Cheers.
Listen, Raymond wants that delivery. Of course I've got a list, then. But why can't you? Well, why can't you handle it? Look, do you know, Matt, just... Look, don't start, all right? Just text me the guy's number and I'll deal with it, all right? Well, you trying to give me a heart attack? What are you doing here?
Nice to see you, Tay.
What's up?
It's Maria. She's got herself into a bit of bother.
With who?
Sean. No, he's just not tell her.
Listen, come on. You better be inside.
He wanted her to go to this client's flat, but...
Why didn't she with me?
I tell her about this guy. He's pervy. Likes to hurt girls, but... Look, I was just trying to give her an idea of what to expect.
She just doesn't get it, does she?
Well, she's new. She still thinks she's got a choice.
Maybe we can get Sean to get rid of this client if he's that much of a problem, you know?
Waste of time.
Why?
Well, he's some sort of big-shot lawyer. I know he's dug Sean out a few holes in the past.
Hey, okay. Look, I'll take you back.
I'm headed elsewhere.
You want us lawyers?
Sean's insisted.
Good afternoon, sir. Can I help you?
Yes. I heard this place was up for sale and I would like to buy it. I'll give you a tenner for it.
Take your dark horse, come here.
So you're pleased?
Pleased? I'm thrilled. It's fantastic.
Does he know what he's letting himself in for, poor boy?
Oh, I think he's got a pretty fair idea.
Too right. So, why don't we meet for some champagne after closing and we can seal the deal?
Perfect.
All right, see you in the ship.
See you later. Right, Mr. Bossman, what are you still doing here?
Eh?
Get yourself home, get your glad rags on, and when I'm finished here, it's party time.
You're on. You are looking at a man of importance, a man of status.
I am. Pleased to meet you.
I'm the new owner of the salon.
What?
Well, I didn't mention it to you before because I thought that it just wasn't going to happen. And then I told Deke this morning that Hayley'd offered me a buyout. Next thing I know, Deke's agreed to put up the cash and we're going to be business partners. Isn't that amazing? What is it?
You didn't think to ask me.
Well, I thought you'd be okay with it.
No, I mean, why didn't you come to me for the money? Why did you go to Deke before me?
Oh, I never asked Deke. He offered.
He offered because he knew about it.
Listen, you have done so much already that... Honestly, it never even occurred to me to ask you for more.
Well, I didn't mean to hurt you. I didn't.
Robbie, we're not sharing a flat. We're sharing a life.
I know. That's exactly how I feel, honest.
Then please, let me be the one to help you.
How do you mean?
Come here. What's Deke's investment?
$8,000.
Have you signed anything?
No.
I'll put up the money.
How can you afford that?
I've got a nest egg, a family inheritance. It's just sitting there waiting to be used.
And you do that for me?
I'd do anything for you, silly.
Why will I tell Deke?
Thanks for earlier.
Yeah, I think you should.
Well, I was way out of order.
Yes, you were.
Well, I'm genuinely sorry, okay?
Okay, accepted. Oh, I take it you got your advance then?
Yeah, they were really good about it. Said I could pay up the balance over the next few months, so that should tide us over.
Till Lenny's next move?
No. I think he's got the message all right.
Yeah, he'll be quaking in his boots.
You can give us a hand if you like.
Is that Stuart here?
Oh, we're back in business, boys.
Yeah, thanks to Gabriel and his contacts.
Brilliant.
What's going on?
Going to give Stevie a hand with all this and he'll fill you in.
What, he's working here again?
Zinny.
There's a lot more to load after van. Come on.
Don't you get up a tea with me?
Just like old times then, eh? Come on.
Your lunch.
Aye, aye. Raymond sent reinforcements, steady.
What's he on about?
Nothing.
Nice, no. What do you mean?
The ship got turned over last night.
What? And you didn't tell me?
I'm telling you now.
So was there much taken?
Well, I think the gantry got ransacked.
Oh, no.
And Raymond came round and, well, he's blaming Lenny.
Oh, that's what Lenny's on about. Cheeky swine. Don't let him have done it.
Oh, I don't think so. I think Raymond's getting the wrong end of the stick.
Oh, aye, because Lenny's such a good guy, ain't he?
Look, don't just start Scarlett, eh? I mean, he was upset. I think he's just jumping to conclusions.
Oh, aye, I know what you mean, because Lenny wouldn't get involved in something less, would he?
Scarlett.
Raymond's your pal.
I know.
So you should stick by him.
I will. It's just I think it's too easy to blame Lenny right away.
And if you tell Raymond this? Oh, some pal you are.
That's uncalled for.
How'd you take it?
Well, he wasn't very pleased.
I will better go round and apologise then.
For what?
For taking Lenny's side.
No, I didn't.
Aye, you did. I don't care if Lenny's no involved in this. Your pal's your priority, Jimmy.
He was being unreasonable.
Sophie was. I am not asking you. I am telling you, you get round there and you start out with Raymond. Do you hear me?
Aye.
Now, I don't normally in working hours, but, the hell with it.
Ah, you deserve it.
Cheers, big man.
Dunno, Hatch.
Cheers.
So the delivery van there. I see you got it sorted, that's great.
Yeah. Lenny Murdoch doesn't always get his own way.
Like I say, I'm just glad you got it sorted.
Even if you're still in denial.
I've not changed my mind, if that's what you mean.
He's got you brainwashed, innit?
Look, Raymond, can we not just agree to put this behind us, eh?
All right, so you carry on defending Lenny. What do I do? Stand back and admire your loyalty?
Well, you're not married to Scarlett.
Oh. She's hacked off you've sided with him, ain't she?
Have you spoken to her?
Don't need to, mate. I know her.
Well, that's maybe part of it, but...
But nothing!
Look, I'm trying to make amends here.
Too late! Why don't you run back to your big boss man and tell him Raymond Henderson's no pushover?
I'm not his messenger, Larry, right?
No? You tell me he didn't send you down here to see what was what?
How
can you say that to me? We're mates.
You have a funny way of showing it, mate.
I've never met such a throwing, stubborn pig headed.
Oh, that's not very friendly now, is it? Oh, by the way, Jim.
You're barred. Thanks, Raymond. Anytime.
What?
Dan? Dan?
Same again?
Why not?
Yeah, I'm finished.
Bailey, I've got something to tell you.
You're pulling out.
No, not at all. It's just that I've got a new backer.
Who?
Will.
Right, and what about Deke?
Will's keen for it just to be me and him. I should have spoken to him first.
So Deke's just out, is he? How did he take it?
I haven't told him yet.
You haven't told him?
I've just had the conversation with Will, and you're the one that needs to know first.
No, what you mean is you had to get me to agree first.
Yes.
How can you dump Deke just like that?
I didn't want to, but...
But what?
Hayley, I'm in love. Really in love this time, and I don't want to blow it.
What kind of a relationship is it, Robbie, if he can just overrule you like this?
That's not what he's doing. Not at all. I hurt him by not asking him about this. And he's shown me how much he loves me by putting this money up. Hayley, I can't just ignore that.
Even if it means dumping on your pals?
I know. Hayley, help me out.
Okay, fine. We'll go with Will if that's really what you want.
It is. Thank you.
But no celebrated drinks until you've met Deke and told him what you've done.
I will. Sorry.
Save that for Deke.
Gonna come with me?
No. Call me when you've sorted it.
Hey, Paul.
Cheers.
Go back to normal then, I see.
Looks like it, eh? Right, boys, what are you after? On the house.
Two large whiskies, two chasers.
Let cheers, Raymond, but I'll pay for it this time, eh?
No. I insist.
Pay for whiskey I bought in.
I know, but Raymond will be good for that money. Don't worry.
Let's hope not.
What?
The clock's already started on his interest. He owes me double already.
That wasn't the deal.
It is now.
Why didn't you tell me this?
Why didn't you tell me that Angie had been to see you?
Well, you just got here. I never had a chance.
She was late for a client. He complained. I called her and she said that she'd been to see you. What's all that about?
Well, I'm running those two girls for you, right? So I don't need to check in with my every move, okay?
Is that right?
Here you go, boys.
Cheers.
Enjoy.
Raymond, I was thinking of having a few friends over later, for a card game. Is that all right?
Sure, huh?
He doesn't deserve this.
He's a loser. I'd be a much better landlord than he is.
It was you who turned this place over last night, wasn't it?
Not me. It was Lenny. That's Raymond.
Next time you're feeling sorry for your wee pal out there, just remember your poor brother banged up in a cell, right?
Why should I help you, Anderson?
Look at it this way. It means Sean's practically setting up shop right through the wall for you.
Aye, well, you know the old saw about friends and enemies.
Well, come on. Isn't that about too close?
No. It means I've got him right in my sights.
And what about Raymond?
Collateral damage. Look, this is an opportunity for me and you.
But not for Raymond.
Hey, family comes first. You nail Sean. Your brother's off the hook. So we just sit and we watch. Agreed?
Hiya.
Oh, hiya. Is Hayley here?
No, she's going to meet us a wee bit later.
Okay. Well, let's get the drinks in.
Dee, can I speak to you a minute before we go in?
Sure.
Can we go down here?
Aye. Worried about this.
Yeah. Deke, actually,
listen, there's nothing to worry about. That's why I said I would handle all the boring business left with Hayley. You just enjoy the champagne. Zinny, can we get a bottle of bubbly, please?
No, Deke, don't do that.
It's not for us. We need to save some for Hayley.
So, what's the celebration?
Well, Robbie and me are going to be taking over number 18 when Hayley goes.
Wow! That is brilliant. Congratulations.
Thanks.
So, are you going to rename it?
I don't know. I hadn't really thought about it. But suggestions are welcome.
Dos amigos.
Keep them coming. You'll be fine once you've had a drink.
Hey.
Hey.
Something wrong?
No. So what's the big secret? Us.
It's my way of saying thank you for helping me out.
What, a receipt for football tickets? What?
For you to take Connor and Adib.
So I'm the good guy now, eh?
Gabriel, you are never the bad.
Well, I'm not a good guy. You don't know the half yet.
I'm trying to...
If you had any sense at all, you'd keep your boys well away from me.
Gabriel, I understand your resentment. Please, I'm trying to make amends here.
And I'm just trying to give you some good advice.
I know how much you've missed those boys. And believe me, they've missed you too.
All right. I'll take them.
Thank you. Let me... I really want to thank you properly for helping out with the boys.
I told you it was nothing.
I could buy you dinner sometime. I mean, we could all go, you, me and the boys.
Happy families.
No, just a nice time, hopefully.
Don't think so.
It's up to you, of course.
Well, I better get going. I'll see you around.
Yeah.
Get those under new management posters done for the windows, and maybe some flyers as well. I even thought we could put an advert in the local paper. What do you think?
Sounds like a great idea.
Yeah. Just heard the news. Well done, you two.
Sweetheart, bring a bottle of malt, four glasses.
Number one, I'm not your sweetheart.
You could be, if you played your cards right, yeah.
And number two, we don't do spirits by the bottle.
Check it out with Raymond. It'll be fine. I've got a tab. And boys, have a warm up.
That guy over there says he wants a bottle of malt and it'll be okay with you.
No, he's at it. Just get him doubles.
He says he's got a tab set up, is that right?
Yeah, that's right.
How much for?
Look, just keep a running total, okay? We'll sort it out later on.
Hayley.
You okay with our deal?
Well, I can't say I'm pleased about the way Deke's been treated.
Robbie rushed into this headlong without even talking it through with me.
Well, it is typical of him, I know. And if I'm honest, it does make more sense for the two of you to go into business together. If Deke hadn't offered first.
It's messy. I know. I genuinely wish it wasn't. And I want to make it right.
Okay. Well, I got fed up waiting for Robbie to call. Have you heard from him?
No, but I'm meant to meet him in the pub later, so...
Hope it went okay with Deke.
Look, boys,
the short arm of the law.
No sign. Raymond, is Robbie here?
He's in the beer garden.
Here, it must have gone all right.
Oh, yeah. I made him save you some champagne.
Cheers.
Cheers.
You're taking it well.
I haven't told him yet.
Told me what?
I tried, I just couldn't do it.
Robbie, what is it?
Will's putting up the money for the salon.
Instead of me?
Yes.
And you've agreed? Obviously.
Jake, sit down. We can talk about it calmly.
What is there to talk about? No, Dee, wait, come back!
Robbie, maybe you should let him go.
No, I can't. Dee, you've every right to be mad at me. I understand, but...
Do you know, I worry for you. I really do. You have allowed that guy to take over your life.
No, I've allowed Will to share my life.
Did he suggest ditching me?
That's not how it happened. He explained that had he known how much I wanted it, the money would have been there.
Robbie, he did know. How could he not have known?
I knew about the sale, but that was before Hayley made me this special offer.
Which means that when there was no chance of getting it, he didn't feel the need to put his hand in his pocket.
No.
Yes, Robbie, yes. And he couldn't bear the thought of somebody else stealing his thunder. He could have done this for you so easily in the first place.
Deke, I admit I've handled this badly, terribly. And I'm sorry, but that's not fair in Will. It's not about you, it's about him and I committing fully to each other.
Dress it up any way you like. The guy is a control freak, and he's got you exactly where he wants you.
Dee, can we still be pals? I don't want us to lose our friendship over this.
Right now, Robbie, I don't know. I really don't.
Yeah. Hey. What's on? MasterChef.
Boring.
You should have seen this guy. He was crying before they've even judged his food. Just want to hug him.
Button.
Big girl's blouse.
How was the football in the end, boys?
Fantastic.
It's better than this.
Good, I'm glad to hear it. There's some leftover pasta if you want it. No, I'm fine. Feeling quite tired, actually. I might head up for an early night. Where's Stevie? Oh, he got a shift at the ship. Great. I'll see you in the morning, then. Night.
Night.
Bust.
Sean, no money on the table. There's a cop at the bar.
It's only at the end of each hand. Eh? Look, we're using matches.
I don't think he's going to be fooled. Oh,
trust me, eh? He's not that clever.
Come on, Sean.
All right, Mr. Landlord, eh? Get me a pen and paper, right? We'll take notes. Right,
another one. Are
you getting your
bother?
No, it's fine, no bother.
Stevie? Double body and tonic, please.
Is that a good idea, mixing that with champagne?
No, that's why I'm doing it.
Right, I'm going up the road.
You haven't even touched that drink.
You have it.
I thought we were going up the tune.
We can do it before I leave.
Oh, Hayley, no.
Robbie, she wants to go home.
Okay.
I'll talk to you tomorrow about lawyers and stuff.
Yeah. Night.
Oh, come on. This is turning into a wake. Stevie!
Robbie, you sure?
Yes, I am. All right.
Oh, jeez.
Sorry. Raymond, see that Sean guy? Is he giving you hassle?
Oh, no, not at all, no. I've just been going over the order and I don't think I've got enough whiskey and I think we might run out.
It's all right. We'll just water down what's left.
You can't do that.
I was joking.
All right. Of course, sorry. Look, I'm just a wee bit frazzled right now with all that break and carry on, you know.
I'll wake you up and get an early night. I'll shut the show up with Zinni.
I'll be fine. I better get back to you.
Okay, we're out for the ditch.
No, Robbie, we're done. Come on.
You may be, I'm no. Raymond!
Robbie just wants to say goodnight. Come on.
No, have another drink.
Robbie, I am not about to argue with a cop.
But it's a conspiracy.
Raymond, is everything okay there?
Yes, just a friendly game of cards. They're fine.
If he gives you any bother, just let me know, all right?
There's no bother, Will. Thanks.
Come on. It's home time.
I'm a bad person.
No, you're not a bad person.
You like me, don't you?
Robbie, everybody likes you. I love you. Come on.
Well, that's good.
Isn't it?
Things are just warming up now. We'll need a lock-in, eh? It's going to be a long night.
What?
A lock-in.
I don't do lock-ins.
I'm getting a distinct feeling, eh? That your gratitude isn't all what it should be.
Look, Sean, I'm grateful for all that you've done for me, but I draw the line at breaking the law.
Aye, well, I'm sorry to disappoint you, eh? But you already have.
Have what?
That delivery you took today, eh? It's knocked off.
There was paperwork assigned for it.
But these guys are pros. They always make it look kosher. In case anybody's watching, it shouldn't be. You signed for Zip, your cop pal that just left. Keen as mustard, Tim. So, have we got a lock in or no? Good man.
What did he say to you?
What are you talking about?
Raymond, drop it. You look like you've been scalped in the guts. What did he say?
I don't want to involve you, son.
I'm already involved, ain't I? Now tell me.
Stevie, son. I have dug a hole for myself. That booze we got today, it was knockoff.
That Gabriel done the dirty on you?
Actually, I got the booze from Sean.
Oh, don't tell me that, Raymond. You know what that means, don't you? Sean did it. He did the pub last night. I guarantee it. How come you never asked me about him?
I didn't think you knew him.
I know enough.
But Gabriel said it would be all right.
Why would he say that?
Why didn't he set you up, Raymond?
So why blank men hide in here in the dark? You vouched for Sean.
Well, I told you. It was your call. You didn't have to take the offer.
Come on, Gabriel, that's a cop-out. What are you getting out of this?
Nothing. Absolutely nothing.
You expect me to believe that?
No, I don't. But it's the truth.
Why are you doing this, then?
Well, I can't tell you that. Except that I didn't have a choice.
Sean's threatened you.
Look, Raymond, the less you know, the better.
The less I've got every right to know. I'm the one that's getting a doing here.
Well, I'm sorry. My hands are tied.
Well, that's just dandy, isn't it? Thanks for nothing.
You're barred.
I deserve that.
Anything.
I was way out of line. I was...
treating me like that?
Yeah. And for that, I am truly sorry.
Get lost.
So, what's brought on this big apology? I know now who did the break-in. And it wasn't Lenny.
Like I told you. So? Who was it?
Better not say. It'd be safer for you.
That's very considerate.
I am in deep trouble. I know you couldn't care less about me right now. But I really need a favour.
Well, do you?
I need to speak to Lenny. And I know he won't want to.
Can you blame him?
No.
So, a quick apology and Jim will fix it.
He will listen to you.
You humiliated me in front of people.
I'll make it up to you, Jimmy, I promise.
The problem is I can't do the right thing, eh? Isn't that what you said?
I'm begging you here, Jim. You're going to help me. Listen, I really appreciate you seeing me.
What do you want?
I really need your help, or at least some idea how to deal with it.
Oh, this is rich. Tell me, should I fish you for a wire first?
I made a mistake.
You made a few. What was that this morning again? A low-life scumbag, how'd it go again?
I'm sorry.
You're sorry? And I'm supposed to be what exactly? Grateful? Pleased, eh?
It's just that this morning...
You found your pub ransacked and you blamed me. And you're that angry at me. That you can't see, even though it'd be obvious to a blind man, that the guy that comes to your rescue, he's the guy that done it in the first place. Your friend and saviour, Sean. Am I right?
Did Gabriel tell you?
No. He didn't have to. How do people you get through life, eh? I know it's not me. How hard do you think it is for me to figure things out?
Why didn't you tell me this morning?
Let me refresh your memory. This morning you told me I was a guilty party.
But that still doesn't explain why you...
Well, I wanted to see what he was going to do. Now I know.
What about me?
What about you?
I just got thrown to the wolves.
And I should care.
Why is Gabriel involved with this guy?
Who said he is?
He told me to take Sean's offer.
It means nothing.
He said tonight there was things I shouldn't ask about for my own good. What's going on, Lenny?
That was good advice you got.
What did I do?
You? You do what you like. I look after myself. If you don't mind.
Earlier for a look this morning.
Good man.
Did you get a result?
No, I'll tell you about it later. You should get home.
I'm not going anywhere. I don't like the idea of you being here on your own with that.
Thanks, son, but I'll be fine. Go now.
Where you been?
I was down the cellar changing a barrel. You want a drink?
No. I've had a bad run. I need another couple of £100. Just get out of the till for me, will you? You can take it off what you owe me. Come on, I've got to get back. Bringing all around the drinks.
You can't win if you don't play. It's a deal, boys. It's all about the money, boys.
There goes another couple of £100. I can't do this. There's nothing left.
So what are you saying?
This has got to stop.
We haven't even started yet.
Coat, bag now.
What?
Go home. You're suspended.
You can't suspend me.
That man needs kept away from my family.
All we've got at the minute is your word against his.
Were you drinking at work this morning?
I'm closing the door.
Deal with this now. We might be able to stop it becoming a disciplinary matter.
Get lost.
I have to formally ask you to come to a meeting tomorrow to discuss this with the partners.
Well, next Tuesday evening, at the usual time of 8 o'clock, you'll find River City over on BBC Two Scotland. Next tonight, here on BBC One Scotland, turn back time to the 70s. Was it a golden age for families? Gripping new drama on Two with the conclusion to the police thriller Line of Duty.